Welcome back to Wake Up West Texas. Hey, where is Malik today? I'm actually live out here at the Stevens Central Library. You're taking a look at a beautiful display that the San Angelo Genealogical and Historical Society have put up here in the library, all to get ready for the 9th Annual Genealogy Fair, which is happening tomorrow right here in the SAGHS Community Room. Joining me now to talk all about it is my friend, the very intelligent Miss Susan Ball. Good morning.
Good morning, Malik. How are you doing this morning?
I am wonderful. Because, you know, I love talking about this event every year, 9 years strong. For people who do not know what the Genealogy Fair is, tell us about it.
Well, it's an accumulation of different exhibits from people who are historically oriented in San Angelo. Like, we'll have Fort Concho, we'll have Fort McCabot. We've got a lady who does tartan weaving, illuminated threads. Pam Gerard has an exhibit. We have a lot of the heritage societies, like the Daughters of the American Revolution, the Daughters of the Republic of Texas, and the Sons of Confederate Veterans and groups like that. And then San Angelo itself, the Genealogy Society itself, has 8 to 10 exhibits where we will sit down with people one-on-one and show them how to use websites to find their family.
Wow. Tell me about what made you all want to start this event, because this is something I have never seen in so many different cities. Tell us about why you wanted to start this.
Well, we were interested in promoting our society. We wanted people to understand what we were about, to get interested in what we do, to join as members. And so we thought we'd have a party. And before we knew it, we had a big party.
Yeah.
And we've done this now for 9 years. We typically have like 100, 150 people show up. And one lady who is a friend of mine came by and told me when she was done, she says, "Susan, this is like genealogy on crack."
Right?
It is so fun. It is a ton of fun.
Because you're bringing the resources to the people, which I think is so important. For people who have come before, what do they say about the event? Do they love that you are showing them how to research their family history?
We do. We have a lot of people who come and they just want to know a little bit more. They want to learn a little bit more to figure out how to find their family. One of our most popular exhibits is the DNA exhibit.
Yeah.
We'll have one or two ladies there with laptops, and you can sit down and you can learn the very basics about why I would want to do my DNA, and then if you have your DNA, a little bit more about how to discover new cousins from your DNA and what you can learn about your ancestry from DNA.
I love that. Now, you're taking a look at the beautiful exhibit that you all put up. We cannot not talk about this really interesting one that is right over here. Come on over here. It's a children's mock wedding from 1921. Explain to people what we're looking at here.
Well, this is an exhibit that was put together by Lisa Mahler, and her family was heavily involved in the Christian church here in San Angelo. One of their fundraisers one year was what they called a midget wedding. And you would think, well, did they have... I would call them height-challenged people involved. Mm-hmm. And though they were children, they dressed up the children like the groom and the bride. They had attendance, and they had a program and the whole thing, and people paid money to come watch the children participate in this mock wedding. Just a tremendous event. They did it several years, and in the 20s, it was a popular type of thing amongst groups to do a mock wedding to raise money for particular projects they had going on.
This is absolutely amazing. So they weren't midgets, they were children.
And midgets probably is not the proper term to use anymore, and it doesn't come to mind. But no, they were not adults. They were children, little ones, like 5 and 6 years old. Can you imagine them?
And they didn't really get married, right?
No,
no. It was just a mock wedding. Was that illegal back then? You know?
Yeah.
Well, hey, I will tell you this. First of all, looking at this exhibit, it is absolutely phenomenal. You need to come and see it. This is the last day it's going to be up.
It may come down at 9. I don't know the gentleman who's involved in it, but there's a new exhibit coming in tomorrow.
Oh, exciting. Well, hey, one thing we do know is that genealogy fair, it is happening tomorrow, October 1st, right here at the Stevens Central Library. You're seeing all of the information on your screen, 6 p.m. to 8 p.m., 2 hours. Come on out and find out more about the family history. And, okay, don't go anywhere, because coming up next, we're going to show people how can they get started in finding more about their family history. Susan Ball will be staying with us. Make sure you stay with us, too. We're live out here at the Stevens Central Library. Susan, phenomenal as always.
Thanks,
but you know this, Al. You know this already. We'll be right back after this break.